Welcome to Respond.io. In this video, we'll show you how to navigate the messages module for your day-to-day tasks and use it efficiently to increase productivity. At the end of this video, you'll know how to find contacts who start inbound conversations, how to prioritize contacts to stay productive, how to understand contacts' needs and send messages, and how to find contacts to start outbound conversations. Let's start with finding contacts who start inbound conversations. In the messages module, there are inboxes. These are folders that organize contacts. There are two primary inboxes, mine and unassigned. If your company uses automatic assignment, you'll find contacts assigned to you in the mine inbox. If your company uses the picking method, you'll find contacts to pick from in the unassigned inbox. There are also other inboxes. The all inbox displays all contacts. Team inboxes shows contacts assigned to users on a team. Custom inboxes hold contacts filtered by specific criteria. Depending on your access level, you may or may not see these inboxes. You can also collapse the inbox drawer to have more space for messaging. Now, we'll learn how to prioritize contacts to stay productive. It can be hard to handle multiple contacts simultaneously, so here are two strategies to help get your work done faster. One, you can prioritize contacts by response time or resolution time. If you want to prioritize response time, sort your contact list by newest message. If you want to prioritize resolution time, sort them by longest open. You can also prioritize contacts who respond faster. Snooze slow replying contacts to hide them from view so you can handle the active ones first. Don't worry. Snooze contacts will reappear here when they respond. Next, let's learn how to understand contacts' needs and send messages. To understand contacts' needs, you can review their chat history and check their contact details. The chat history shows all messages and comments, while contact details shows the contact's information such as phone number, email, etc. Understanding a contact will help you send better replies. To send messages, you can use the chat box to send text with emojis, drag and drop files or images, and even record voice notes. Open the camera app on your mobile, scan the QR code, click on the link, and download. If you find contacts asking a frequently asked question, you can use snippets to send a canned response. These are pre-formatted replies created by your manager. If a contact doesn't reply but has other channels connected to your workspace, use this drop-down to switch the channel and send them a message there. If you need help responding to a contact, you can tag a colleague or a manager in a comment and they will get a notification. Once you finish chatting with a contact, you should close the conversation. Finally, let's learn how to find a contact to start an outbound conversation. Sometimes, you need to message a contact with a previously closed conversation. Here are two ways to find the contact. If the contact is still assigned to you, go to the Mine inbox, select the close filter, and type the contact's name, phone number, or email in the search bar. If the contact is no longer assigned to you, go to the All inbox, select the close filter, and type the contact's name, phone number, or email in the search bar. Once you have found a contact, you can send a message to start an outbound conversation. Remember, you may have multiple channels to choose from to start the conversation. Looking to reply messages on the go? Don't forget to download our mobile app available on Google Play and App Store. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment down below. Thanks for watching and don't forget to give this video a like and subscribe to Respond.io for all things business messaging.